Hi everyone, welcome back to integralcalc.com. Today we're going to be talking about how to find the cross product of two vectors. The vectors that we're given in this problem are a equals 5, negative 1, negative 2, and b equals negative 3, 2, and 4. So these are not in component form. They're not, you know, the numbers we're given in here are not coefficients on I, j, and k. We can just take these two vectors and go straight into finding the cross product. The formula that we're going to need is just this this strange formula. It's a grid, a third order determinant grid of positive and negatives that tells us what signs we're going to put on our second order determinants. You'll see how it works in just a second. This problem isn't too hard, especially if you're given just two vectors like this with the numbers already broken out for you here. But the first thing that we're going to do when we have a problem like this and we're given these two vectors is we build a third order determinant matrix here. We're always going to put I, j, and k in the first row in this order. So go ahead and write I, j, and k out in the first row. And then we're going to take our direction numbers here in A, A1, A2, and A3, and we're going to put them here in our second row underneath I, j, and k. So 5, negative 1, and negative 2. And then we take B1, B2, and B3, and put them in our third row as negative 3, 2, and 4 here. And that's all we do. That kind of sets up our problem for us. So it's always I, j, and k, then A, then B in the first, second, and third row. And now that we've built this third order determinant, we can go ahead and break that out into second order determinants. So here's what that's going to look like. And this is the way that we break it out. First of all, you'll notice that we have I, j, and k here multiplied out in front of our second order determinants. That's always going to be the case. You can go ahead and put I, j, and k out in front. The thing that we need to remember, and this is the reason that we have the formula up here, we're always going to work from this formula. We start with positive in the upper left-hand corner, and no matter how big your matrix gets, you follow this checkerboard pattern of positive, negative, positive, and then you start the second row with a negative. Just make a checkerboard with your, you know, positive signs and then fill in the rest with negatives. But what this tells you is that we're going to assign a positive sign to I, which is the variable we have here in the upper left-hand corner of this matrix, and then a negative value to, in our case, j right here, which is why this j here is negative. And then k, of course, is positive because k is the is in this position here, and when we look at our formula and we follow this checkerboard pattern, k is a positive based on this right here. So that's why we get positive I, negative j, and positive k. And no matter how big your matrix is, you can follow that checkerboard pattern. Now, as for the second order determinants here, the way that we're going to do it is the following. For I, what we have multiplied by I, we're going to take our third order determinant, look at it, and we're going to eliminate everything that's in the same row and the same column as I. So in our case, when we're looking at our third order determinant, we're going to eliminate 5 and negative 3 because they're in the same column as I, so we're going to ignore them. And then we're also going to ignore j and k because they're in the same row as I. So we block out everything in this row and everything in this column because that's where I is. And we're only going to look at what remains, which in our case is negative 1, negative 2, 2, and 4. And so you see, that's why those four numbers come over here to this second order determinant, which gets multiplied by I. We've got negative 1, negative 2, 2, and 4. And then we're going to do the same thing for j and k. So let's just look at j and practice one more time. For j, we're going to eliminate everything in the row with j. So I, j, and k here get ignored completely. And then we're going to eliminate everything in the column with j. So in our case here, we're going to ignore negative 1 and 2. Everything here gets ignored. And everything else gets translated in the same orientation over to the second order determinant. You don't mix around the numbers at all. You just move them in their position right over. So we have left 5, negative 3, negative 2, and 4. And so they move over in that order, 5 being in the upper left-hand corner, negative 2 being in the upper right-hand corner, negative 3 in the lower left, and 4 in the lower right. And then we do the same thing with k, ignoring the row I and j, and ignoring the column, negative 2 and 4, So we end up with everything left, 5, negative 1, negative 3, and 2. So that's how we build out our second order determinants. And the reason that we do that is because once we have, we're going to do some multiplication that allow us to simplify, and then we're going to get our final answer for the cross product. So the way that we do that is, let's look at I here. We're going to have I times whatever we've got in the second order determinant. And what we do here is we multiply what's in the upper left-hand corner time what by what's in the lower right-hand corner. So we do negative 1 times 4, which is going to give us a negative 4. And that goes in the first spot here, negative 4. Then we're always going to subtract. See, we have subtraction, subtraction, and subtraction. We're always going to subtract, and then we multiply the lower left and the upper right. So 2 times negative 2 is a negative 4. So we have negative 4 here in this second spot. So upper left times lower right minus lower left times upper right. And we follow that same pattern. So you'll see with J here, we bring this negative J down from here. And then we have upper left times lower right. It's a diagonal pattern here. 5 times 4 is 20, so we get 20 in the first spot. Always subtract. And then negative 3 times 2 on the diagonal again is a positive 6. So we're going to get 20 minus a positive 6. And we're going to do the same thing with K. So we build that out. And once we've done it, all we have to do is simplify. So we'll get negative 4 minus a negative 4 is going to be negative 4 plus 4, which will give us 0. 20 minus 6 gives us 14, and 10 minus 3 gives us 7 here. So we simplify, and then we'll do one more simplification step where we just make these coefficients. So, you know, you've got 0i minus 14j plus 7k is as simple as we can get. And the reason I left out this 0i is because these coefficients now, 0, negative 14, and 7, are going to be the three direction numbers that are going to compose our cross product vector. So our final answer is going to be the vector 0, negative 14, and 7. And that ends up being the final answer for our cross product, which we just pulled directly from here, these coefficients on I, J, and K, 0, negative 14, and 7. So I hope that helped you guys. Not too bad for cross product, and I will see you in the next video. Bye!